Yo, what's going on guys, it's Vizier, back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be going over some tips that will help you improve when switching to keyboard and mouse. If you do enjoy this video, make sure to drop a like, and if you're new to the channel, make sure to drop a sub as we're on the road to 1000 subscribers. Finally, if you want to support me even more, make sure to use code VIZEXD at the Fortnite item shop. When you first switch to keyboard and mouse, the first things you're going to want to get sorted out are your sensitivity and keybinds. When it comes to sensitivity, when you move your mouse from one side of your mouse pad to the other, you should be able to do a full 360 degrees turn. You can use that as your starting sensitivity, and you can increase it or lower it later on, depending on your playstyle. When it comes to ADS and scope sensitivity, I recommend putting your ADS anywhere between 20% and 50%, and then put your scope sensitivity anywhere between 5 and 10% higher than your ADS sensitivity. For keybinds, it's a bit more complicated. I'm going to leave a link in the description for this video by Isjerian, where he goes over the most optimal keybinds. This video is really helpful for people who just switched to keyboard and mouse, and it is also helpful for people who have been playing on keyboard and mouse for a while but aren't feeling comfortable with their current keybinds. Once you've got your settings sorted out, you're going to want to hop into a creative world and practice building. When you switch to keyboard and mouse, you're going to have to learn the mechanics you knew on controller all over again. I recommend spending your first 2 days on keyboard and mouse in your own creative world, by yourself, practicing basic builds and edits. You should practice normal ramp rushes, 90s, and basic cone edits or wall edits. And by the end of day 2, you'll see a massive improvement. Once you've mastered all of those, you should spend some time practicing your editing. But one way you can do this is by using this edit code map, which I'll put the code in the description, and just practice different types of edits. In my opinion, editing is the most easiest mechanic to learn from keyboard and mouse, so I don't recommend spending too much time on it. Another important mechanic you're going to want to practice is your aim. Aiming is the hardest mechanic to learn on keyboard and mouse. Mobile players have aim assist, which helps keep their aim consistent, but on keyboard and mouse, there's no aim assist whatsoever. This means to get your aim anywhere close to where it was on controller, you're going to have to practice a lot in creative or Kovac. I recently made a video on my aiming routine, so if you want to check that out, the link will be in the description. But if you don't want to watch the full video, I'll put a code up for an aiming routine map. After 3 to 4 days of practicing keyboard and mouse by yourself in creative, you're going to want to play box fights or 1v1s with a friend. At the beginning, you're probably going to keep misplacing your builds and missing a lot of shots. But as you keep playing, your aim and other mechanics will gradually improve. Another thing you can do is play zone wars in one of these free-for-all maps. Zone wars really helps you improve your mechanics because you're put against 15 other players and you have a storm constantly at your back. You probably get even more improvement with playing zone wars than box fights, because in box fights there aren't any zones and it's just you 1v1 against someone. Okay, so if you've been doing everything up to day 6, you're ready to go into public games. But instead of going straight into solos, I recommend playing a few team rumble matches. The reason I recommend this is because when you go straight into solos, your builds are going to be a bit shaky and you're going to miss a lot of shots. This will make you lose a lot of fights, which will get you sent back to the lobby. This means you're missing out on time that could be used practicing a bit more. On team rumble, when you die, you just respawn straight away. So what I like to do in T-Rumble is practice looting and I just push everyone I see. When people die, they respawn in the air. So another thing I like to do is try using my AR to try shooting them out of the air to practice my tracking aim. I only recommend playing T-Rumble for 1 day because most of the players aren't as good as if you go into a solo game. Okay, now that you've done everything I've mentioned in the video, in day 7, you can finally start playing solo. A lot of YouTubers recommend hot dropping every game and try to get as many kills as you can. But personally, I don't recommend this because it will lead to you dying on spawn almost every game. Instead, what you should do is land somewhere far away from the battle pass and get 1 to 2 kills of spawn. Practice looting efficiently and quick, and then take a couple of mid-game fights. If you make it to endgame, play for the win and only take fights that are necessary. You should keep playing like this until you're comfortable with playing solos on keyboard and mouse, and then you can start to play a bit more aggressive. Anyways, that's gonna be it for this video on how to improve quickly in 1 week on keyboard and mouse. Make sure to keep practicing your mechanic even after the 1 week so you can keep getting better and better. But anyways, that's going to be it for this video. So if you did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like. And if you're new to the channel, drop a sub. And finally, remember to use creator code RiseXD in the Fortnite item shop.